good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss about first lesson in 7th class biology, that is food components. In this lesson we are going to discuss about different components present in different varieties of food items. We know that we are eating different varieties of food in our day-to-day life. What kind of food we are eating? For breakfast, we are eating different varieties, for lunch and also for dinner. We people won't show interest if your mother is giving daily the same variety of food. It may vary. We like to have different varieties of our tasty food. Is it right? If someone asks you about your favorite food, you may think about your favorite food. Immediately you get some saliva into your mouth. Is it right? Yes. If I ask you what is your favorite food, you may tell, different people may tell different varieties like payasam, biryani, chicken, egg curry, potato curry. Like that, we may tell different varieties of food items. It may vary from person to person. Sometimes it may matches with two people also. Then what are the different varieties of food containing different components? What is meant by components? Here we are going to discuss about the nutritional values of the food. From your primary classes, you have one idea what varieties of nutrients are present in the food. If we talk about such kind of nutrients, means the components present in the food, here we have to discuss about a list of components present in the food. What are that? If we talk about different varieties of food, here components present in the food, that first one, carbohydrates. You are well familiar with this, carbohydrates. And the next one is proteins. Carbohydrates, proteins, and then fats. Carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals. And here, along with carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals, food also contain some of important components in it, that is water and fibers. These fibers are also called as roughages. A balanced diet, it may contain all these nutrients along with water and fibers. Fibers we also called as roughages, means which may give some healthy body. In a person who looks healthy, have to eat. If you have interest to become a healthy person, then you have to eat all these nutrients by consuming different varieties of food. Most of the people, if they have interest to take omelette, always they ask their mother to prepare omelette. By eating only single variety of food, are we able to get all the nutrients into our body? It is impossible. Means everyone have to eat all varieties of food, then only we look healthy. If you have interest to take only milk, are you able to get remaining all nutrients present in the food? No. That's why, though you have interest, if you don't have interest to take all varieties of food, also you have to take, it is must and should everyone have to take all varieties of food, then only we look healthier. If we talk about carbohydrates, the carbohydrates are also called as energy-giving food. Carbohydrates are also called as energy-giving food. Along with the carbohydrates, fats are also called as energy-giving food. If we talk about proteins, these are bodybuilding food. If you want to get muscles to your body, more muscles like a bodybuilder, then you have to take more amount of food which is containing proteins like eggs, chicken, mutton, milk, fish, everything you have to take if you want to build your body like a bodybuilder. That's why we call the proteins as bodybuilding foods. Okay, fats are also called as energy giving food like carbohydrates. If we talk about vitamins and minerals, these are the protective foods. They protect our body from different varieties of diseases. If you want to be healthy, then you have to add more varieties of fruits and fresh vegetables. Then more amount of vitamins and minerals will be added to our diet. Then we look healthy and protective from different varieties of germs. Okay, do you understand, children? These are the different varieties of components present in the food. And now we have to know about, does the food variety, the food what we are eating, are they contain all these components really? How can we believe it? By testing, by experimenting. Now we are going to discuss about test. How to test starch and how to test the presence of fats in the food. Okay, first of all, we are going to know about presence of starch in the food. The starch is absolutely related to the carbohydrate. If the food containing starch, means it contains carbohydrates. Okay, if you want to know about different varieties of components present in the food, then you have to take different varieties of foods. For example, here I take milk powder. Okay, you take a packet of milk powder. Along with that, you also take different varieties of food like potato chips packet, biscuit packet, whatever it is, oil packet, milk packet, whatever it is, you may take packaged food. If you observe on back side or the front side of the packet, you may get, you may find the list of ingredients, what kind of ingredients we are using. You already well familiar with the ingredients definition in your 6th class. Is it right? And here you have to write how much amount of carbohydrates are present, proteins are present, fat is present, vitamins and minerals are present. Along with that, other, if any other components are present in that packet, you have to mention there. Everyone note down this tabular form and try to write in your notes. You may add many examples like this. Here I took milk powder, potato chips. By your interest, you may take any 5 examples. By seeing that, you may write. By seeing that either carbohydrates are present, then you write present, and how much amount they are present, you have to mention there. Okay, do you understand, children? First you have to write carbohydrates present, proteins present, like that. If the packet contain carbohydrate, then you have to write present. How much amount? If it is present about 10%, then you have to write 10%. Like that, you have to fill this tabular form. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the first experiment in this first lesson, that is test for starch. Okay, test for starch. For this test, we need iodine solution, dilute iodine solution. How can we prepare that dilute iodine solution? Take a test tube and add a little amount of iodine solution to it. Later you add some amount of water till the color of the iodine solution changes to brown. Okay, then now the dilute iodine solution is ready. You take some amount of dilute iodine solution and add to the sample what you want to test. If you want to test rice powder, then you add some drops of iodine, dilute iodine solution. If you want to test any kind of food like biscuit or potato, a piece of potato or milk, any kind of food, the sample, if you want to know about the presence of starch in any variety of food, whatever it is, if you want to test rice, then you have to take a small amount of rice in the test tube. If you don't have test tube, then you may take a bowl. Okay, add rice And again add little amount of about 4 or 5 drops of dilute iodine solution. Mix it well. Within a few minutes you may observe the color change, that is a dark blue in color, either black color. It indicates the presence of starch in that sample. Okay, if the food is not containing starch, then the color of the sample, it won't changes. It remains the same. For example, if you take rice in a bowl and we are adding dilute iodine solution to it, mix it well. Within few minutes you find the color change, that is dark blue. It indicates that rice contains starch. Starch is present in the rice. Means indirectly it is telling that the rice contains carbohydrates. The starch test indicates the presence of carbohydrates. If the sample contains starch, then the color changes to dark blue. Sample color changes to dark blue. I think you understand this test. Okay, first step. Test. What is that? Test for starch. If the sample containing starch, it indicates the presence of carbohydrates in it. Any kind of sample you are able to take for this test. Okay, next test. Second test, that is test for fats. It is very very easy. Even small children also able to do this test. Okay, for this test, you have to first select the sample, any variety of sample, and a white paper. White paper. For example, if you want to test dosa, you just take dosa onto the paper and gently rub that dosa to the paper. If you want to test puri, then you take that and gently rub to the paper. If you want to test chapati, if you want to test vada, or if you want to test rice, then we just take that sample and rub on a paper. Whenever the food contains oil or fats, it indicates, means the paper turns into translucent. Translucent means the paper itself, it turns into translucent, means transparent. We are able to see from this side to other side very easily by using that paper. And you are able to identify while we are eating any vada, chapati, oily food like puri in a paper plate, then we are able to find some oil is sticking to the plate. And the plate also turns into translucent. We are able to find by keeping that paper near to the light, then we are able to see other side of that paper very easily. That is called as translucent. I think you understand. It is very easy when compared with this. Here you need only sample what you want to test, and another one is a white color paper. Later what we have to do, we just take the sample and we have to rub that sample on a paper. If the food contains oil or fats, then it turns into translucent. It indicates the presence of fats in that sample. Okay, I'll meet you soon in the next session. Thank you.